Hey, what's up guys, Jeremy here. In this video, we will learn how to import heavy 3D models to RoboDK. We'll learn how to do so without compromising the fluidity of your general simulations. Let's get started. Some of you might already have experienced something like that. You import a 3D model to RoboDK, a heavy one, and after a few minutes, it does appear in the 3D environment, but it's very hard to move it around. It seems a bit laggy or unresponsive. And if you try to run a robot program that was previously working just fine, it feels like the robot is lagging quite a bit. So that's normal, but it's not something that we want to have to live with. So I'm going to show you how you can import heavy 3D model without compromising the general fluidity of your simulation. Let's see how it goes. So here I have RoboDK station, empty one, and here under, in the same folder as we used before, we have lasertracker.step, and here it's 101 meg. So it's relatively heavy without being like too big, let's say. So I will first go to tool and then options, and under CAD here, I will bring back the default settings. Here under defaults, I think you have accuracy of surface 1, angular accuracy of surface 2, and curve accuracy 2 millimeters. As I mentioned in a previous video, the lower those values are, the more accurate the imported 3D model will look inside RoboDK, but it will also be way heavier because it creates a lot more surfaces or little polygons and triangles. If you were to select fast import settings, here 555, we can change them if you want to have something like in between. It will create a more rough 3D model, but a lighter one for sure. So here, that's a decision you can take. If you can, if it's possible for you to just go for a very high importation setting and you don't really care about the accuracy of all curves and everything, and you're just going to look at the 3D model from afar, that can work. But if you want to retain as much detail as possible and still have a fluid station, I will show you how to do that. So let's go for default importation settings, so 112, and click OK. I'm just going to go and make sure that in general or display I have nothing specific activated for now. OK, click OK. Then here I will drag and drop my lasertracker.step. So here you'll see at the bottom of your screen, it says loading from the folder and then the file. So that's the first indicator that the file is currently loading. Generally with smaller 3D models, you won't even have the time to or get the time to see that. It will simply pop in directly because it takes, let's say, less than a second to load in. And another thing that I want to show you, so if I close that here, here you will see you have your little loading icon from Windows. And if you click here on it, you will see that everything becomes white and it says RoboDK not responding. That's kind of true and that's kind of a lie at the same time. So the 3D interface or the UI of RoboDK is not responding because RoboDK is kind of keeping all the resources it has to do the conversion of the 3D model you imported from the step file format to RoboDK's format. So in this case, it's not really gone, so you don't need to close it and go to Ctrl-Alt-Delete and just close the process. It will come back at some point. If you want to know if it's the case, you can just go to your task manager and make sure that RoboDK is actually increasing the memory usage. Now it went down after a few seconds, but if the memory usage is increasing, that means that it's currently converting the 3D model to something that is usable for RoboDK and stacking it in on the RAM. So here. Okay, so what we imported here is a laser tracker. It's a laser tracker, so that's cool. So first of all, I have a very good computer. So even here, a 100 meg file isn't too problematic here. You will see here at the bottom of my screen, I have a frame counter. So FPS or millisecond for how much time it takes to create a new frame. this is a very useful tool if you want to know if your station is getting heavier, or if one of the parts that you imported is just getting heavier or kind of is a bit power hungry. So if you want to see that little frame counter, you can go to tool and then option, tools options. Under display, you can select under display text on screen, you can select render time. So render time here, if you uncheck it, it will disappear, and check it, it will reappear. So I have a very relatively powerful computer with a high-end 10-gen Intel processor, 32 meg of RAM, gigabyte of RAM, sorry, and a powerful GPU, or mid-range 20th gen GPU. Anyway, the point is that even with heavy object like that, I can still get about 30 frames. So 30 frame is good enough for some fluid motion and everything. But if I was to hide that object here, you would see that generally I'm sitting around 63 because I'm kind of capped there. I capped it out so that I don't generate like 100 frames per second for no reasons. But the point is that here, if I make it visible again, I'm kind of dropping my frames by two by having just that one object. So that doesn't give me a lot of headroom, let's say, to add more objects and have things moving around and still keep stuff fluid. I would say that under 20 frames per second, you will start to see stuff being a bit laggy. So if you can stick or stay over that, that would be awesome. So here, if I just add a few frames, I'm going to show you here if I... Here I have one, that's Control C, Control V, and then Control V, and then Control V. So now I have four of those, and I'm at like 8 FPS. And as you can surely see right now, it's not very fluid, like it's more like appearing here and there. And if I was to continue like that, at some point I would have a lot less frame and it would be almost unusable. If you hide some 3D objects, those won't be rendered, so they won't count in your frame count. They won't affect your render speed. So if you, so this is a good way, I would say, using the hide option and the frame counter here to figure out which object in your station is problematic or which object is heavier than the rest, and therefore address the issue the way I'll show you in a few minutes. So let's delete all the others. I don't, oh, by the way, yeah, another thing. They are not counting towards the render time if they are hidden, but if they are just selected like that, they obviously show on screen, and it's even worse because they are kind of semi-transparent, so you have to render what's inside of the render and all. So that will affect your render time. So the point why I'm telling you that is that if you say visible like that, if you just select one, right click, visible, and you don't see the any difference on your counter or frame counter, that's normal, because as long as it's still selected here, it's semi-transparent and it still affect your frame count. And as soon as you unselect it, it disappears. Let's delete all of those. Perfect. So why is this one heavy? So if I double click on it, it will go for more options, change colors. You will see that now in the last example I showed you with the little icon, we had like 88 white triangles or polygons, a few blue ones, a few gray ones. Now we have almost 14 or 15,000 polygons just for one color here. So that's pretty heavy. If you were to here try to remove one color, press zero here, you would soon realize that it's not a good idea. Here, those are useful, so you need to bring them back like this. Okay. So one solution you have to this problem is the following. You can right-click and then group mesh. Here, it went from 14,900 and something polygons to one. So it kind of stacked all the polygons onto one single layer. So I can do the same for the other one here, group mesh. And by doing so, as you can see now, I'm back at 63 FPS and I can copy that. Let's go for here. I'm just changing. Oops. Like that, and then like this. As you can see, I have 4, and I'm still at 63 FPS. So, kind of rearranging the polygons onto a same onto the same rendering layer will help you reduce the stress on your RoboDK station, and therefore keep more frame or have a higher frame count per second. So that's very cool, but it has some drawback that I need to show you in the next video. But that's one solution. Here, I will close this one because now I kind of modified the station or the 3D model in a way that I can't go back. So right click, group mesh is the same way as right click, delete mesh. It's a one way road. You can't go back or you can't revert back. Control Z won't have any effect. So here what I did for you so that you don't have to reopen it or reweight another time. So a heavy step file, that RDK, if you bring that one up, it's the exact same file, but yeah, already imported. So it's easier for you. I showed you the other day or in the last video that if you can right click and then save as SLD. If you save at SLD as SLD here and click save here, if I create a new frame, so control frame here, this one, and I go back to my folder, and let's say I am importing the tracker.sld that I just imported. It's the same exact 3D model as this one here. Not simplifying anything, just there. So if I bring it here, it's visible here. And as you can see, it took only a few, like a fraction of a second. So it didn't have to recompile or reprocess every phrases and convert them to RoboDK's format. So that's one thing. Another thing you can do to simplify the object is to go to Tool, Options, and then Display. So I'm going to show you in the next video how you can use these, let's say, settings here to further reduce the stress on your computer. And I'm going to show you also what are the drawbacks of using such a feature. I hope it was helpful. In any case, have a great day, guys.